Good evening, students. Here we are going to discuss about a new topic, temperature scales. So we have seen different temperature scales in our daily life, centigrade, Fahrenheit and Kelvin. So normally centigrade scale is Celsius or centigrade, both we will use Celsius scale or centigrade scale that we are normally using in our laboratory, and Fahrenheit scale for the weather report. And for Kelvin scale, for the conversion from centigrade to Kelvin, to use it as a SI unit. Mainly, centigrade and Fahrenheit scale is not used as a SI unit, but Kelvin will be used as a SI unit. Because in centigrade scale, we have zero. So, I cannot be able to use zero as normal freezing point of water. So, if we put zero, the each and every term present in the thermodynamics thing or thermal properties of matter will become zero, absolutely zero. So there will be no energy. But there is energy at 0 degrees Celsius also. So I cannot be able to use degree Celsius in certain, because of certain reasons. So it becomes zero. But it is not exactly zero. We have other thing called absolute zero. At that time only there will be no movement of solid particles or liquid particles or gaseous particles will be there. There will be no gas at that time. It is absolute zero means it will be, everything will be in a solid form. So no movement of particles at that time, that is -273 degrees Celsius, it will be not attainable easily. So that is referred as 0 Kelvin. So we are using Kelvin as a SI unit scale instead of these two centigrade and Fahrenheit scales. Now let us see the difference between these three scales. We know that 0 to 100. Why we are using 0 to 100? Because water is a standard substance we are using in our daily life. So according to that, so the freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius and boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius at standard atmospheric pressure. We already studied the pressure lesson. In the pressure lesson, normal atmospheric pressure, 1 atmosphere is 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. So at that range, the freezing point and boiling point of water will be 0 and 100. Similarly, in Fahrenheit scale, the freezing point will be taken as 32 degree Fahrenheit and boiling point as 212 degree Fahrenheit. What is the difference between these two? Here we have only 100 divisions. But in this scale, we have 180 divisions. But the Kelvin scale is different. That is same as Celsius. Only the number has changed. If it is 0 degree Celsius, here we will add 273 to get 273 Kelvin. 100 degree Celsius, 373. So 200, 473, 573, like that, we will add 273 along with the Celsius value, directly we will get the Kelvin scale. Then what about this Fahrenheit? Actually, this is number of divisions, 180, here it will be 100. So if you equally divide each and every division, one division corresponds to 1.8 division of your Fahrenheit scale. Here, one division in your Celsius scale will be corresponding to 1.8 division in your Fahrenheit scale. Then 1 degree Celsius means 1.8 degree Fahrenheit, not like that, because it starts from 32. It is not starting from 0. It will be slightly a different thing. So that we will discuss in some other classes. First, let us see about this reason. So 1 division is 1.8, but here 1 degree Celsius is not 1.8 because it starts from 32, so it will be 33.8 degree Fahrenheit. So how to correlate these two scales? Let us see about that. So let us consider a small formula to convert Celsius to Fahrenheit scale and Fahrenheit to Celsius scale. So here we know that degree Celsius has 100 number of divisions and Fahrenheit scale has 180 number of divisions. And we know that in Fahrenheit scale we start from 32, so we are subtracting the 32 value, because to get the Celsius scale, if I put Fahrenheit as 32, 32 minus 32 will become 0. So Celsius scale will be 0. So here Fahrenheit scale 180 divisions, so dividing it by 180. Here it has 100 divisions, so I am dividing it by 100. So now you can convert, you can simplify this also. So on simplifying this, so this will be how many times you can see. So on 10 it will be 5. 20 into 5. So this will be degree Fahrenheit minus 32. 20 into 9. So if it is 0 degree Fahrenheit or 0 degree Celsius, you can consider easier thing. 0 degree Celsius is dash Fahrenheit. Dash degree Fahrenheit. So 0 degree Celsius means, so we want to put how much amount of Fahrenheit. So if you put 0 here and rewrite these terms, so this is pi and 9. So here the Fahrenheit scale you are going to calculate. So bring this 9 this side. So this will be 5, this will be 9, so it will be 0. So here we have f minus 32, the whole term will be 0. So f is equal to 32 degree Fahrenheit. So this is the relation. Just we have checked whether the relation is correct or not. And the other thing you want to know, in exams or in IIT exams, JEE mains, they will ask you one important question from this. At a certain degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit, both are same. For what value it will be? Same. Both the scales are same. But temperature is same, scale value is also same. Not at all the values. Here it is 0, here it will be 32. But for that scale alone, for that scale value alone, we have both the temperature same and the magnitude values for Celsius and Fahrenheit are same. You consider minus 40 degrees Celsius. Just substitute here. So minus 40 by 5, that will be equal to F minus 32 by 9. Now rewrite this. So 9, 4, 36. So it will be minus 360 by 5. It will be equal to F minus 32. So now rearrange this. So 5, how many times it will be? So 5, 36, 5 5s are 25, 6 are 30. So it will be 5 7s are 35. So 72. Five sevens are 35. So 570, 350. So 572. So if you rewrite this, bring this 32 to the side plus 32. Again, the Fahrenheit scale also I am getting as minus 40. So degree Celsius is also 40. Similarly, Fahrenheit scale also minus 40. Both are same for this value. This they will ask you in accommodative examinations. So that's all about the temperature scales and the relation between Fahrenheit and Celsius and also with Kelvin. So we'll see a different concept the next session of 11th. Thank you.